One of the things that's really interesting about this period of illuminated manuscripts I'm studying, it's called the Insular Period. The manuscripts were made from about 550, 600 to 850 until the Vikings came in and wreaked havoc. So you've got about this 250, 300 year period of time where the Irish and the English, actually the Saxons, are kind of inventing a way of visual expression. I'm driven to try to figure out what these monks were up to in their visual expression. To do that, I need access to these manuscripts. And the digital makes that possible. Printing facsimile versions is just too expensive. The other problem with doing the printing of facsimiles is that we need color. That for me to go in and, you know, someone from Kentucky here, to go in and digitize this manuscript and then start unlocking its secrets. And when I start unlocking some of its secrets, since it was made around probably 60, 70 years before the Book of Kells, by the time you get the Book of Kells, they're taking techniques to such extremes, sometimes it's hard to figure out what they're trying to accomplish. But by moving back to the Chad Gospels, I get an early look at those techniques as they're developing, and I get a better sense of their expression. Their focus, suddenly, although they contain the Word of God, was more important or just as important, the expression visually. And so they start developing techniques where they can move text around on the page to make room for imagery. So suddenly we have the word not as a oral phenomenon or even as a literate phenomenon as we think about it for meaning, but as a visual phenomenon, as in typography. And I thought that my time with the Book of Kells would be shorter than what it's turned out to be. Because there's so much mystery in the imagery, having a rhetorician approach it is much different than having an art historian approach it or a medievalist approach it. So I'm able to ask slightly different questions, particularly questions thinking about the making, thinking about invention, thinking about rhetorical memory, that aren't at the heart of the other disciplines. Here in just this small little area, in my little corner of the world, the digital is opening up all sorts of possibilities. And then when we start being able to compare the Chad Gospels to the Book of Kells, pulling images side by side, then we can really look at these things and start understanding them. When we start doing things like encoding the decoration, we don't know exactly why they have these minor decorated initials, the letters within the Gospels themselves with decoration on them, some decorated, some not. They don't necessarily follow verses or chapters. There's something else going on with them. They are connected with Eusebian canon tables, lections for various readings for services, but we don't really know exactly what's going on. Once we have these manuscripts encoded, we can start comparing between manuscripts, and where they are similar, we can probably come up and gradually through the process of elimination, figure out what they're visually expressing with these particular decorated initials. So just at kind of, again, my little corner of the world, it's opening up all sorts of possibilities for scholarship, for us to understand these manuscripts and actually see their correspondences in ways that we haven't previously.